Hi, I'm Mitch Gallagher from Sweetwater. Think of vocal mics. If you're like most people, one of the first ones that will pop into your head is the Shure SM58, one of the best-selling microphones of all time. The SM58 has been used countless times, both in the studio and on stage for vocals, of course, but also for instruments. It's a super versatile mic that you're definitely going to want to have in your mic locker and your PA rig. The SM58 is based on the original Unidyne capsule, which Shure developed back in 1937. The super rugged Unidyne 3 version of this capsule, which was created in 1959, was used to make the SM58 in 1966, and it's been used around the world ever since. The SM58's capsule is a dynamic moving coil design, and this is a big part of why it's so rugged. It's a mechanical design. It can handle high volume levels, high humidity, high temperatures, and you can drop it, kick it, and knock it with no problem. Some engineers have even claimed they can use the SM58 to hammer nails, although I don't necessarily recommend doing that. The point is that once you have an SM58, you'll have it for life. They're almost impossible to break. Now, the SM58 has a cardioid polar pattern, which means it's basically heart-shaped with the focus of the microphone in front. This helps to reject sound from the sides and rear very well, helping control bleed from other instruments and noise on stage and in the studio. The SM58 has a controlled proximity effect. It's not overbearing, but it helps add fullness and richness to vocals and instruments when you get up close. The SM58 has a frequency response from 50 Hz to 15,000 Hz. This is wide enough for everything from bass to detailed percussion and other delicate sources. There's a strong presence peak that starts around 2,000 Hz and rises up to around 7,000 or 8,000 Hz. This is huge for helping vocals cut through a loud mix on stage and provides excellent articulation in the studio. The low frequencies are controlled, so you never get too much boom or rumble. Now, the SM58 has some great features that make it ideal for vocal applications. For example, there's an internal pneumatic shock mount that helps to cut down on handling noise. The mesh grille and built-in pop filter help control wind and breath noise, and they cut down on problems with P-pops and other plosives. And as I mentioned, that presence peak really helps the vocal cut through a dense or loud mix. The SM58 couldn't be easier to use on vocals. You can pretty much just point it at the singer's mouth and get great results. But you'll get even better results if you learn to work the microphone a bit. By getting closer in, you can take advantage of proximity effect for a fuller sound, then pull back for louder passages or for less low end. For the fullest sound, you'll want to sync straight into the microphone from a distance of 6 inches or less. You can get right up on the grill for the bassiest, fullest sound. For a more natural sound, pull away from the mic by 8 inches or so, and try moving it slightly off axis from the singer's mouth. This will reduce proximity effect and help reduce P-pops and sibilance or S sounds. Now, it's pretty common to use the SM58 as a handheld mic on stage and even in the studio. In this situation, avoid sliding your hand around and hold the mic firmly to prevent handling noise. You'll also want to avoid covering any part of the grill with your hand, since this changes the polar response and sonic characteristics of the mic. Hold it farther down on the body for the best results. To control feedback on stage, be sure to keep the rear of the microphone pointed toward any stage monitors. The null for the polar pattern is directly behind the mic, and aiming this at the monitors will give the best feedback rejection. But the SM58 is a super versatile microphone. It can certainly be used on many sources besides vocals. It works great on brass instruments, just trumpet, and it also does well on saxophone. I've used an SM58 many times on guitar and bass cabinets on stage, and in this case, you'll want to try to get close in to take advantage of the fatter sound from proximity effect. It can also work well on snare drum and toms. I like to aim the mic at the spot where the stick hits the drum head for the most attack. With any instrument, experiment with placement. Just moving the SM58 a small amount can make a big difference in the sound it produces. The SM58 can handle extremely high sound pressure levels, so you'll have no problem using it on loud guitar amplifiers, on loud drum kits, and in front of horns. But it's sensitive enough to use on acoustic instruments as well. I've seen SM58s on acoustic guitars and even on grand pianos. The SM58 is an ideal vocal microphone for the stage, and you'll also want to keep it handy for vocals in the studio. And it's so versatile, when you're done with vocals, you can use it on guitar amps, drums, and much more. Definitely a microphone you're going to want to add to your mic locker and live rig. Thanks for joining me today. I'm Mitch Gallagher from Sweetwater. Thanks for watching. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Click here for more videos like this, or start at sweetwater.com for all your music instrument and pro audio needs.